Welcome to my channel Progress with Professor Mahamani. Thanks for your continuous support. Friends, this video I am going to talk about 12 common mistakes made by the PhD students. So let us go to the first one. The first mistake is selecting the silent supervisor than the appropriate supervisor. So initially at the time of selection of supervisor, the PhD students normally they do this mistake. They want the silent supervisor, so who cannot comment on their work, he will not check his progress. So this kind of things they will expect. So at the beginning it will be good. So at the time of writing article, doing research and thesis editing, everything, we will miss the valuable guidance. So if you are selecting appropriate supervisor, then he will properly guide your work, he will monitor your work, he will help you to complete his PhD, complete your PhD well in time. So this is advantage. If we go to second one, selecting PhD topic away from the specialization. Suppose some people, they are in design specialization, for the compulsion of supervisor or some other problem, he will select the PhD topic in thermal engineering. So he is from design specialization, then he shifted to thermal engineering. So this difference, it will give lot of trouble. So for research work, the fundamental is very important. So especially if you are doing research within the specialization, it's not at all a problem. Already you have a lot of foundation on that work, right? You have some basic knowledge on your research, so that it is easy to proceed your research work. So otherwise it is very difficult. So learning new topic, I mean thermal fundamentals, and slowly progressing into the research, then it will take a lot of delay in doing research, clearing the articles and thesis writing, everything. If you go to third mistake, the selecting the topic without considering the four parameters. So this parameter already I discussed in one more video. Number one is cost, time, latest technology and the quantum of work. So we will go one by one. First of all, some people they will select the research work in costly topic. For example, metal additive manufacturing, that setup is costly. Even making a small sample, so you need few lakhs. Or otherwise, doing research in nanotechnology, purchasing nanoparticles, nano ceramics, 1 gram, 1200 rupees, including GST will come. So these are all the costly research work. So if you are taking costly research work, then it will create a financial problem at the end. Second one, the time. Cost is very less, it is the latest technology. You will have a quantum of work, but it will consuming lot of time means, then what happened, your thesis, thesis or thesis submission process, it will get delayed. If you are missing 1 year, then what happened, you have to pay 1 year fees. So in terms of fees and other loss, it will give a big trouble at the end. And third one is the latest technology. So selecting the PhD topic in the latest technology is very important. Some people they will select the PhD topic in the outdated area, then they will struggle to publication. So you can complete your pre-PhD, you can do your work, but throughing the article, right, or processing to the journal publication, the editor they will ask the latest technology. What is the novelty of your work? What is the latest technology? What is the area of application? So this area you will face a lot of problem at the end. Then fourth important parameter is the quantum of work. Some people they will select the research topic in such a way that you can publish only one article. So this will not sufficient. So generally in my opinion, if you want to complete PhD, three journals are required. One is Scopus Index, and the second one is SCI with a low impact factor, then third one is SCI with a high impact factor. Meanwhile, some literature review or some other foundation work you can publish into the conference, you can present in conference. So at least four articles are required, minimum four articles are required. Some people they will select the topic, we can't publish four papers, then at least three papers are required, otherwise it would be a big problem. While thesis editing, it will create a lot of problems. So many things, it will go, thesis, it will go away from your publications. So then again, it will be commented by the thesis examiners. If you go to fourth one, selecting the coursework subject away from the research topic. So this, one kind of people, they used to do this. they will do the research work in the design area. They will select a pre-PhD topic or course work in the manufacturing, like manufacturing technology or design for manufacturing. Or design for manufacturing is okay. They will select the topic like advanced casting, advanced welding, that is no way connected with the design. So that what happened at the time of doing the research, people will struggle without the basic knowledge. So if you are selecting the coursework or pre-PhD subject, so close to your research topic, then it is easy. So you can gain all the basic knowledge, so that it is easy for journal publication or YOOs, or their any question asked by the either PhD examiner or journal editor or reviewers, so you can easily can answer. And if you go to course one, the prolonging the coursework or pre-PhD work for many years. Some people the course duration, PhD course duration is 4 years. Some people they will prolong up to 3 years, they will prolong the coursework. So 4 subjects are there. First year they will take 2 subjects, second year they will take 2 subjects, like that they will go like that. So if you are prolonging your coursework, then what happened? Your research work, it will get delayed. So the right practice is, you need to clear your pre-PhD or coursework. All the 4 courses you need to complete within first attempt, so that your entire coursework, it will be completed within first year. Second year onwards, you will put more attention for your research work, so that we can do some good publications. So that leads to in-time thesis submission. So if we go to 6th one, identifying the problems from the open access journal or old research articles. So this is one of the common practice in many of the PhD scholars. Some people they will identify, simply they will go to Google search, they will download the open access paper. Based on the open access paper publication, they will identify the problem. So what is the problem for this is, you have some reputed journals are there. These are all closed access, only you can see the abstract of this journal. If you are identifying problem from open access journal and going for publication, this problem already solved by some other author that will be published in the closed access journal, like reputed journals. So that problem will come. So that while identifying the problem, we need to refer the reputed journals apart from the open access journal. And reported also, you need to look at the latest research article. So latest research article, if you are finding identifying research problem based on your research work, already published work, that is published 3 years before, then what happened? Within 3 years, somebody did this work. So that problem will come. So that what to do? We need to go for reputed journals. One more thing is the latest journal, reputed and latest journal, both are important. Some research scholar, they will prepare the research problem from old articles, some articles 5 years old, 6 years old. From this, they will identify the problem. Finally, if they are going for publication, at the time of submitting their paper to journal, then editor screening itself, he will inform this problem was solved by many author, like that. So putting this reason for rejection and simply reject. If you go to 7th one, not using the latest research facility in order to fulfill the peer-reviewed journal requirement. Generally, peer-reviewed journal requirement, they will ask the latest research facilities, so not outdated one. Some research scholar, for the sake of money, for the sake of time, they never go to latest research facility. So of course, these research facilities are available in all the research center, IITs, NITs. So they are ready to give for consultancy also. So what to do? We need to identify wherever research facilities are available very near to you. Straight away you go and request, and you will get the consultancy. So you need to do your work there. Otherwise, what happened? If you are doing work with outdated research facility, so it will be commented by reviewers, editor, so that it is very difficult to through the publications. So this is one of the important thing. For example, nanotechnology, previously people, they will go with the SEM, based on the SEM picture, they will write the report. So now you have a TIM facility, it is available in all IITs, few NITs also having, and many research centers, they are keeping the TIM facilities, so that you can go and you can get the time slot and you can do your work, so that that leads to good quality publications. If you go to 8th mistake is, not using advanced graph software and equation editing software. So not using advanced graph softwares. So simply they will use the Excel sheet for drawing, for generating graphs. So sometimes it will very good, some critical readings, the Excel sheet, it will not give good graphs. Or all the graph line, it will coincide with one or the other, so that it is very difficult to distinct. So that, so we need to go for some advanced graph software. It is available, many advanced graph softwares are available in the internet. And you can download the trial version and you can do it. And another important one, the equation editing software. For article everything, you need to use equation editing software. Some people simply by using Word itself, they will generate the equation. So that doesn't look nice. If you are using it, equation editing software, so it will be more attractive for publication, so that your article will be published easily. If you go to 9th one, publishing papers in predatory journals, this is one of the blunder because of this attitude or this mindset. Lot of predatory journal people, they generated for within 5 years 380 crores to the end. So previously I discussed this issue in one of my previous videos. So those who are not seeing, you can refer. So pay and publish. So this predatory journal people, they will give some attractive words. They will send an email to every author, right? Our journal is indexed by SAE and we will publish very quickly, right? Very quickly, within a week we will publish. This kind of they will call with this attractive word. Simply they will people go for predatory journal publication. They will collect huge money like 20,000, 25,000, and they will without doing any peer review, straight away it will be published. So later on what happened, UGC CARE and Scopus, they will identify this problem. Poor quality articles are continuously coming inside. If it goes to the notice of Scopus or UGC CARE, simply they will remove. If the journals are removed, then what happened, whatever you did earlier, that work, it will go waste. The 10th mistake is poor connectivity between the thesis and publications. If you are doing very minimum number of publication, then thesis will go away from the publication. So later on this issue will be commented by the thesis examiner. Then that leads to rework, rework and resubmission. So this kind of issues may be expected. If you go to 11th one, not attending the conference and lead to poor networking and poor presentation skills. So if you are not attending conference, conference it is one of the opportunity to meet your group of researchers. So if you are not attending conference, you will lose the networking. Then if you are presenting our papers in conference, so that give a confidence to present your research work at the review meeting and PhD thesis or PhD viva was this area, it will be considered as advantageous. If you go to last mistake, exposing research secrecy to the non-collaborative researchers. So if you are exposing your research secrecy to your research colleagues or is within your research group, there is no problem. And if you are exposing to the unknown people, that means non-collaborative researcher, you will lose your valuable idea. You will do by using your idea, you will do the research work and you will publish the research article. So that you will lose your valuable idea. So friends, I hope this video will more useful to you. For further videos, you subscribe my channel and press the notification button so that whenever I am uploading any new video, you will get an update. Thanks for watching.